So, what's the difference between an active Thunderbolt cable and a passive Thunderbolt cable? Well, an active cable has little electric chips that boost the data, increasing the distance your data can travel along its path. A passive cable does not. And those little chips? Well, that's why active cables cost more. Ignoring for a moment that despite its straightforward appearance, a data cable actually has a lot going on inside, we're just going to focus on the data. Now, data running across the cable can only go so far before the integrity of that signal starts to degrade. And the faster that data's running, the faster that degradation occurs. Take the pluggable passive Thunderbolt 3 cable, for instance. At 0.8 meters, you're transferring data at 40 gigabits per second. Now stretch this cable out to 2 meters, and you're only looking at 20 gigabits per second. Now, suppose you needed to run data from your laptop over here to your docking station 2 meters away, or roughly the distance of one standard cow. You're going to need an active cable for that. Take, for instance, the pluggable 2-meter active Thunderbolt 4 and USB 4 cable, for instance, has specialized Intel chips known as retimers that boost that signal along your data path, increasing the distance it can travel. In this case, that's twice the distance of the passive equivalent. It is worth noting that you can get an active Thunderbolt 3 cable, but they tend to only carry Thunderbolt data, not USB. If you need an active cable, stick with Thunderbolt 4. It's a lot more versatile. Let's see what that would look like if our data were little cars. Okay, this will be our passive guy. Let's give him a little push, see what he does. Not bad, made it to the end, kind of slowed down. Let's try that same thing with an active cable. Magnificent. And did you ever notice that every time a newer, faster connection standard comes out, the cables are always a little shorter? Now you know why. So that's active versus passive. Thanks for watching. If you have questions on connections or comments about anything else, let us know. And if you need to get a hold of our support team, that's support@plugable.com. Have a great day, everyone.